This is a question from the Waka Waka Foundation, mm-hmm. and it involves a gift, because this is the Waka Waka, mm-hmm. and I think you know it already.
Yes, but I've never had one in my hand. This is fantastic.
Well, this
but
is
we
yours?
Should, we should be outside, eh?
Yeah, but it works. Great. You can push it.
Yeah, can I push it here? Yeah?
Yeah. Look, on the other side.
Yeah, fantastic. Yeah, it's great.
Yeah, and it could ban kerosene on a really, really large scale in especially poor areas. Mm-hmm. And also because you can charge it for only a few hours. Mm-hmm. And then you can use it for over 16 hours.
Yeah, fantastic. So, but this is a good example of innovation. That's exactly what I meant. And there's so many smart solutions that we should try. You know, that this exactly, I mean, you know, this now we know, but there must be a next step and a next innovation.
Yeah.
But this is where you have to...
And use it on a really big scale.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Well, his question is, what can be the influence of the Waka Waka solar light on mm-hmm. especially education?
Well, I think one of the main limiting factors for people is if you're really poor and you live in an area where there's no electricity, and a few people may have generators, but they're expensive to run, means that in the tropics where it gets dark at 6 and it gets light at 6, you have in fact half of the day you have no possibility to read or to learn or even to discuss well. And you may have a few lamps, and I myself lived for many years without electricity and running water, so I know what it is to write my report with 2 candles on the table, but that's very tiring. So it's wonderful to have something that extends the day and gives a chance for people to learn, especially if you're a farmer and you work all day, then you need to be doing any learning at night. Your children help in the farm, and so they also have the evenings. And so if the evening is not lit, then that makes a tremendous difference. So I think this would be really great if every household would get like one like this. But again, the question is, how do we best do this? It has to be part of a bigger plan. Just giving a lamp to a family without an educational program may mean that the man in the family will take the lamp and do his things, and it mm-hmm. won't be used for the whole family, and won't be used for the children, because this is a gadget, and so it has high status, and so the chances are that the most powerful person in the family will use it and not the children. So unless you make this part of a larger program and you provide the teaching materials and you have a plan and you perhaps do something in villages to have something like a competition for the best school class or something like that, then you run the risk of this not being used well. So it always boils down to having an integral approach.